Penguin Random House Audio presents Don't Worry, 48 Lessons on Relieving Anxiety from a Zen Buddhist Monk by Shunmyo Masuno, translated by Allison Markin Powell, read for you by Douglas Hachiya.
Foreword. Pare away the things you don't need. Live an infinitely simple life, free from unnecessary anxiety or worry, without being swayed by other people's values. I hope to tell you how to do that in this book. By nature of being a Zen Buddhist priest, I am consulted by many people about their problems. The variety of what they want to talk about is endless, but if I were to generalize, I would classify them as anxieties, worries, and doubts. When I listen carefully to these concerns, here's what I notice. Almost all of them are in fact delusions, assumptions, mistaken impressions, or imaginary fears. You might even say they lack any substance. How can you be so dismissive, someone might say to me, when you're not the one going through it? Or, I'm so worried about it that I can't eat. It's a little like a Japanese saying about seeing a ghost out in the field when it's really just dried sasuke grasses. What I mean is, there's no reason to be afraid of what might appear to be a ghost, because it's really nothing more than withered stalks. These things that tie us into knots and drag down our spirit are no different. The truth is, if we look at them objectively, we find that we often allow ourselves to fear shadows that aren't really there. Maybe this sounds familiar. Something you were worried about was weighing you down, but then a random comment or occurrence made you realize how insignificant it was, and you're amazed by how much lighter you felt. Zen teachings are a treasure trove for this kind of realization. I wonder what you think of when you hear the word Zen. Perhaps it conjures an esoteric world of lofty and profound ideas. It's true. We do sometimes engage in abstract conversations about Zen koans, but this is misleading. Zen teachings can be very accessible. They are closely connected to our everyday lives. For example, when you enter a home and take off your shoes, line them up neatly, even something as simple as this is rooted in Zen. It is a literal reflection of the Zen saying, look carefully at what is under your own feet. In Zen, we use phrases and sayings called Zengo as part of our training. Zengo derived from anecdotes and scriptures to help us understand the wisdom and practice of Zen. You'll find them throughout this book. Another Zengo, eat and drink with your whole heart, teaches us not to be distracted by unnecessary things. When you drink a cup of tea, focus only on drinking the tea. Or when you eat a meal, focus only on eating that meal. This might all seem perfectly ordinary, but if we take great care to put these habits into practice, we'll be able to focus on the here and now. By doing so, we will free ourselves from unnecessary anxiety, and our mind will be able to settle. So instead of agonizing over what might happen in the future, let's focus only on the here and now. The point is to reduce, to let go, to leave behind. By doing so, we'll be able to enjoy a calmer, more relaxed, and positive version of ourselves. Gusho, Shunmyo Masuno. Part 1. Reduce, let go, leave behind. The Zen way of keeping anxiety and worry at bay. 1. Don't delude yourself. Zen teaches us not to compare ourselves. There is a Zengo, delude not thyself. Put more plainly, it means do not have delusions. You might think that delusions refer to any number of figments of the imagination. But in Zen, the concept of delusion has a much deeper and broader meaning. Whatever lodges in your mind, whatever clings to and constrains your heart, these are all delusions. Selfish desires for this or that, attachments that we don't want to let go of, these too are delusions. Envy of others, feelings of self-doubt, these are also delusions. Of course. It's impossible to free ourselves of every delusion that takes hold in our mind. That is the state that the Buddha achieved. Being human, we must accept that there will always be delusions in our heart and mind. The important thing is to reduce these delusions as much as we can. We're all capable of it. But in order to do so, we must first discern the true character of our delusions. There is a famous quote from Sun Tzu, "Know your enemy, know thyself, and you shall not fear 100 battles. Which is to say, without knowing your enemy, you will not understand what you must do in order to face him. What is the source of these delusions? It is a way of thinking that sees things in opposition. For example, we set up binaries such as life and death, winning and losing, beauty and ugliness, rich and poor, profit and loss, love and hate. Death is seen as being in conflict with life, and when the two are compared, we perceive life as sacred and precious, while death is empty and forlorn. That guy's lucky. I never seem to catch a break. How come I lose at everything while she's always winning? A single experience bleeds into everything. We apply this to our whole lives. Meanwhile, envy of others and feelings of self-condemnation build up inside us until we are consumed by them. Indeed, one could say that we are under the sway of those around us, that we are bound by our delusions. But ask yourself this: what meaning is found in comparing yourself with others? There is a Zengo, once enlightened, there are no favorites. If we apply this to human relationships, perhaps we can accept others as they are, regardless of whether we like them or hate them, or whether they are better or worse than we are, without being carried away by our emotions. The founder of the Soto school of Zen Buddhism, Dogen Zenji, said, "The actions of others are not my own." He taught that what others do is unrelated to what we do ourselves. Someone else's efforts do not lead to our advancement. The only way for us to improve is through our own efforts. Zen teaches that the existence of everything and every person is absolute unto itself. There is no comparison. This is true for you, and true for others. There is no comparison. When we attempt to compare things for which there is no comparison, we become preoccupied by what is irrelevant, and this is what creates anxiety, worry, and fear. When you stop comparing, you'll see that 90% of your delusions disappear. Your heart feels lighter. Life is more relaxed. Don't delude yourself. Think of these words every so often. Let them become a way to cheer yourself on, to say, "I believe in my absolute self, without compare." 2. Focus on now. This is about cherishing ourselves. Some people brood over memories. You might say they are stuck in the past. There is a Zengo, dwell in the breath. Taken literally, it means to live in the moment when you're drawing breath as conscientiously as you possibly can. This also resonates with the Buddhist concept, dwell in the three worlds. The three worlds are the past, the present, and the future. We live in the connections among these three worlds. Though when we find ourselves in the present, the past is already dead, while the future is about to be born. This is how we explain the Buddhist concept of samsara, the cycle of death and rebirth, how everything is born and then dies, and everything that dies is reborn. Put another way, there's no use rethinking the past that is dead and gone, nor should we think about the future that has yet to be born until it arrives. That is to say, all that matters is how we live in the here and now. There is this three-line poem known as a senyu. Even the chip bowl was once a cherry tree on Mount Yoshino. What now appears to be a worn-out piece of china was once a magnificent cherry tree in full bloom on Mount Yoshino, where throngs of onlookers gasped in wonder at its beauty. Our past glory and honor become the foundation for our present state. But this is not only about Yoshino cherry blossoms. Some people seem never to miss a chance to bring up their brilliant past. I worked on such a huge job. I'm the one who made that project a success. Of course, it's important to...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.